Hello viewers, I am Dipti Hans. Today my topic is calorimetry. We all know that each substance is made up of molecules. Molecules are in a state of random motion. It means they have kinetic energy. And they have attractive forces, it means they have potential energy. Sum total of potential energy and kinetic energy is known as the internal energy of the body. And this internal energy of all the molecules constituting a body is called its heat energy. So, heat flows from a hot body to a cold body when they are kept in contact. This measurement of quantity of heat is called calorimetry. Now come to SI unit of heat, because heat is the internal energy. So, what is the SI unit of energy? It is joule. So, SI unit of heat is also joule. Now, one commonly used unit of heat is calorie. You might have heard from your friends that I cannot eat this gulab jamun, it consists of so much calories. So, what is this calorie? Calorie is the heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water from 14.5 to 15.5 degrees Celsius. Now, what is the relation between SI unit and this calorie? So, 1 calorie is equal to 4.2 joule. Or you can say 4.186 joule. As we know that heat flows, but what factor determines the direction of flow of heat? Temperature. Temperature is the parameter which decides the direction of flow of heat of two bodies at different temperature when they are kept in close contact. Now, SI unit of temperature, it is Kelvin. Other units are degree Celsius or Fahrenheit. Degree difference on both the temperature scales is same. If we are taking change in temperature in Kelvin scale, it is change in temperature degree scale, they both are same. We need to add 273 to temperature in degree Celsius, then it converts into temperature in Kelvin. Now, factors affecting the quantity of heat. There are three factors. Quantity of heat is depicted by Q, alphabet Q. It is directly proportional to mass of the body. More the mass of the body, more is the quantity of heat required to change the temperature. Next is, heat is directly proportional to change in temperature. The initial temperature and final temperature. Dono ko consider karenge, then we come to know about the change in temperature. So, heat depends on change in temperature. If we want less change in temperature, obviously we need heat energy which is less in quantity. Third parameter is specific heat capacity. We will consider this in detail. But three parameters on which quantity of heat depends are mc delta t. So, the formula for calculation of heat which we use in numericals also is Q is equal to mc delta t, where m is the mass, c is the specific heat capacity, and delta t is the change in temperature, not temperature. This is change in temperature. Now, let us try to understand what is the difference between heat capacity and specific heat capacity. Let us denote heat capacity by the alphabet C dash and specific heat capacity by small c. So, heat capacity is the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of entire body by 1 degree Celsius of entire body. And specific heat capacity is the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of unit mass. This phrase is very important in this definition. We will consider this while giving number in your examinations. Unit mass of the body by 1 degree Celsius. This is the heat energy required for entire body. This is the heat energy required only for unit mass by change in temperature 1 degree Celsius. So, heat capacity depends on mass. It depends on mass and the substance. But specific heat capacity does not depend on mass because it is the characteristic property of the substance. So, formula for calculation of heat capacity C dash is equal to Q upon change in temperature delta T. Specific heat capacity formula C is equal to Q upon M delta T. हीट कैपेसिटी और थर्मल कैपेसिटी इज इक्वल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मास एंड स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी सी, वेयर एज स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी सी इज इक्वल टू डिवीजन ऑफ दैट इज सी डैश, इट मीन्स थर्मल कैपेसिटी डिवाइडेड बाय मास. यू मे यूज दिस फॉर्मूला इन न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑल्सो. ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ हीट कैपेसिटी इज जूल पर केल्विन, बट ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी इज जूल पर केजी पर केल्विन. अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज कैलोरीमीटर. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सिक्स स्मॉल क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड विद दिस टॉपिक. सो फर्स्ट इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ कैलोरीमीटर. इट इज अ सिलेंड्रिकल वेसल विच इज यूज टू मेयर द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट गेन्ड और लॉस्ड बाय अ बॉडी when they are kept in contact. So this is definition. Now next question is material which is used in the formation of calorimeter. It is copper. Next reason is why copper is used. Because first is copper is a good conductor of heat, so it soon acquire the temperature of its contents. Second, copper has low specific heat capacity. Always make a combination that substance which is a good conductor has low specific heat capacity because it shows a rapid and high rise in temperature. It means it is a good conductor. Now, so reasons why we are using copper in the formation of this calorimeter. Now, how can we prevent three type of heat losses? As we know, three type of heat losses are conduction, convection and radiation. For radiation, we need to polish inner and outer surfaces to prevent heat loss by radiation. To prevent heat loss by conduction, we provide a wooden jacket and some insulating material is put inside this, like wool or cotton can be filled in the free space here. So, to prevent conduction. Now, to prevent heat loss by convection, we have provided a wooden lid over the calorimeter. So, three type of heat losses can be minimized with the help of these simple measures. And last question is, what is the purpose of two holes in this wooden lid? So, one is thermometer to gain the temperature, to measure the temperature, or one is stirrer to mix the contents properly. Now we will talk about principle of calorimetry. If the system is perfectly insulated, this is the condition for this principle to come true. So if the system is perfectly insulated, then heat energy lost by hot body is equal to heat energy gained by cold body. As we all know that the temperature of cold body is less, so it means its temperature increases, and temperature of hot body is more and its temperature reduces. So temperature settles, it means final temperature comes in between these two, hot body temperature and cold body temperature. So this is the principle of calorimetry. Now, natural phenomena and consequences related with high specific heat capacity of water are, so these type of questions can come from reasoning point of view in your papers also, like climate near the seashore is moderate, why hot water bottles are used for fermentation, matlab sikai, water is used as an effective coolant in radiators, etc. Farmers fill their field with water to protect their crops from frost in winter season. All plants and animals have high water content. Stone lying in the sun get heated up much more than the water lying in sun for the same duration of time. All these questions need one answer, that water has high specific heat capacity of water. Some questions may be asked with high and low heat capacity only, like the base of a cooking pan is made thick. Why the base of an electric press is made thick? Because they have high heat capacity और वाई कॉपर इज यूज इन मेकिंग कैलोरीमीटर, बिकॉज इट हैज लो कैपेसिटी, लो हीट कैपेसिटी और थर्मल कैपेसिटी. नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व अ फ्यू न्यूमेरिकल्स. सो इन द गिवन न्यूमेरिकल द मास ऑफ कोल्ड वाटर इज गिवन 8 kg एंड मास ऑफ हॉट वाटर इज गिवन 2 kg. And temperature of cold water is 25 degree Celsius and temperature of hot water is 80 degree Celsius. Now first try to understand, they have asked us to calculate the final temperature. Final temperature is in between these two temperature. It is always greater than 25 degree Celsius and less than 80 degree Celsius. It means it lies in between 25 and 80. It can never be more than 80 and less than 25. So, now according to principle of calorimetry, heat energy lost by hot water is equal to heat gained by cold water. Lost by. Now heat energy lost by hot water means formula is MCT. So mass of hot water is M dash C and delta T. Again here gained by cold water is MC delta T. Delta T is change in temperature. C is same because specific heat capacity of water remains same. For calculation, we need to cancel these C on both sides. If we have taken two different liquids, then we need to calculate these also. Now M dash is given 2 kg and delta T is change in temperature. So temperature of hot water is 80. So we need to write 80 minus T, and mass of cold water is given 8 kg and delta T hot cold water. Cold water is 25. So final temperature is more than 25, so T minus 25. 80 minus T and T minus 25. Keep this in mind. So 160 minus 2T is equal to 80 minus 200. 80 plus 2T transposing, then 160 plus 200, it means 360. So it means 10T is equal to 360. So T is equal to 36 degrees Celsius. So final temperature is 36 degrees Celsius. Now in this given numerical, we need to calculate the time taken by heater. So the power of heater is given as 500 watt. Because it is given in watt, so it is the physical quantity is power. Now the material has mass equal to 50 kg, specific heat capacity is 960 joule per kg per Kelvin, and change in temperature is from 18 to 38. So delta T, which is change in temperature, 38 higher temperature minus lower temperature is 18, so it is 20 degrees Celsius. Now as we all know that power is equal to heat energy upon time, so it implies Q is also equal to PT. And we all know that Q is also equal to MC delta T. So we need to use PT is equal to MC delta T formula here. Now what is the value of P? It is 500 watt. T, it means time, we need to calculate. What is the value of M? It is 50. C is 960 and delta T is 20. 38 minus 18, it is 20. Now time taken is equal to 50 into 960 into 20, and जो time के साथ है वो नीचे आ जाएगा. दोनों zeros cancel, 5 cancel, 96 into 20, 0, 12, 19, 1920 seconds. So time taken is 1920 divided by 60. It means cancellation of zeros, 6 threes are 12, 32 minutes. So 32 minutes is the time taken by a heater of power 500 watt to change the temperature of this material from 18 to 38 degrees Celsius. In this given numerical, water is given, mass of water is 45 gram, temperature of water is 50 degrees Celsius, and specific heat capacity of water is 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin. Try to match the quantity is over here. If it is in kg, then try to convert in gram. If this specific heat capacity is given in kg. So if it is in gram, it is in gram, then you can simply solve them. Mass of copper is 50 gram, temperature of copper is 18 degrees Celsius, and specific heat capacity of copper is 0.39 joule per gram per Kelvin. Now, according to principle of calorimetry, heat energy lost by hot body is equal to lost by hot, which is hot in these two, water is hot. So, by hot water is equal to heat gain by copper, cold copper. So, hot water, Mc delta T, M is 45, C is 4.2 and temperature is 50. We need to calculate final temperature. Again, I lay emphasis on that final temperature is more than 18 and less than 50. So it means 50 minus T, and here T minus 18. Try to remember these points. Gain by copper is mass is 50 and C is 0.39 into delta T is T minus 18. So for making calculation easy, if you can cut anything on these two sides, you may cut. Like this is decimal cancellation, this is 5, 9 are 45, it's 10, 10, 10 on both sides you may cancel. So 9 into 42, 18, 36, 378, 50 minus T, and this side 39, T minus 18. Now 378 multiplied by 50. So it means 18900 minus 378 T and 39 T minus 39 multiplied by 18, it gives 702. After transposing, this 378 comes to that side. Is equal to 702 on this side, so 02619. So T is equal to 19602 divided by 417, it gives 47 degrees Celsius. So final temperature is less than 50 degrees Celsius and more than 18 degrees Celsius. I will try to cover latent heat, its numericals and related phenomena in my next video. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. If I am able to make you understand this topic, then please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.